The Pakistan delegation welcomes the convening of this high-level forum on the culture of peace. We welcome the statements by the President of the General Assembly, by my friend Ambassador Anwarul Chaudhry, and other speakers. The quest for peace is a central and eternal struggle of humanity. Yet, much of our history is a long and tragic tale of conflict, discord, and acrimony between warring factions, tribes, empires, and nations. But mankind has also invested in parallel to contain the consequences of conflict and wars. Humanitarian law has evolved in parallel with the advancement of the weapons of war and the means of destruction. There have been rare moments in history where peace was realized and preserved. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him's Riyasat-e-Madina, is a unique example of governance based on equality, justice, tolerance, and peace. It laid down the foundations for the golden age of Islam in Arabia, Spain, and South Asia, where peace was built on the values of tolerance and cooperation. In Westphalia, the concept of unlimited war was outlawed. The League of Nations was another attempt to establish a peaceful world order. But the United Nations Charter was perhaps the first attempt in modern history to save mankind from the scourge of war. It laid down the principles of state behavior, including the non-use of force or threat of unilateral force, sovereign equality of states and territorial integrity of states, self-determination of peoples, and international cooperation to promote peace and friendly relations among nations. The world order established by the UN Charter and a president prevented another global conflagration for 75 years. It was the best attempt to create a culture of peace. In the past 75 years, mankind has made unprecedented progress towards a world order based not only on power, but on human values. This world order and international peace, however, are now under grave threat. The principles of the United Nations are being flouted with impunity. Conflicts are proliferating and intensifying. The COVID crisis, instead of uniting humanity, has accentuated and revealed our differences and divisions. Intolerance, bigotry, and prejudice are on the rise. Extreme right-wing populism is resurgent. Hate speech has found its way into political and social discourse. Inequality within societies and among nations is widening. The gulf between the affluent and the deprived is growing. Truth has become a victim of expediency. Falsehood has become the currency of discord. Instead of uniting humanity, we are on the path of division. Madam President, Pakistan is committed to peace within and peace across our borders. Pakistan's founder, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, declared, "Our foreign policy is one of friendliness and goodwill towards all nations of the world. We do not cherish aggressive designs against any country or nation. We believe in the principle of honesty and fair play in national and international dealings and are prepared to make our utmost contribution to the promotion of peace and prosperity among the nations of the world." Guided by this vision, Pakistan has always sought to defend the principles of justice and peace. Each year in the General Assembly, Pakistan, together with the Philippines, moves a resolution on the promotion of interreligious and intercultural dialogue, understanding, and cooperation for peace. Pakistan has constructed the world's biggest Gurdwara Sikh temple in Kartarpur to facilitate Sikh pilgrims. Last year, our Prime Minister opened the Kartarpur Sahib corridor between India and Pakistan. The corridor has enabled the Sikh community from India and across the world to visit one of their holiest sites without any visa required. The United Nations Secretary General has termed the project a corridor of hope. Madam President, we support the United Nations plan of action to safeguard religious sites. The destruction of the historic Babri Mosque in Ayodhya and the construction underway of a Hindu temple on its site is a grave violation of international norms, and extremists have held out threats to destroy hundreds of other mosques and historic Islamic religious sites across India. Likewise, the conscious plan to destroy the Islamic cultural identity and change the Muslim demography of illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir is a serious violation of international law, including the Fourth Geneva Convention. The international community must mobilize the political will to promote the culture of peace within and among nations. Pakistan will continue to play an active role in this endeavor. I thank you.
The distinguished permanent representative of Pakistan,